Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. So today we are going to begin with the part 2 of the chapter Reading Works of Art. Kindly read me the textbook, page number 54. In part 1, we have already dealt with the great artist, that is Heather Riza, and in the first part we are going to take just a recap, that is about the famous artist Syed Heather Riza, and he was popularly known as Riza. And in the first part we had dealt about the personal life and the private life, and his choice of colors, patterns and combinations had been described in detail, and his early education and the awards won by him had also been mentioned. And we had seen the various geometric patterns and the most popular and the fascination for the bird, and he also explored the themes of the Prakriti, that is the nature, Kundalini, that is the primal energy, and Tribhuj, that is the triangle. So in the second part, that is the Gone Art. Now Gone Art, in this extract, if you look at this picture, this is an example of the painting. Now the Gone Art, it is a piece of the folk art. Now folk art means the art done by the indigenous people, the locals, or you can call it also, it deals with more kind of the utilitarian, decorative and the beautiful than fine art. Now in this extract we are going to deal with the Gond art. The Gonds are the largest Adivasi community in India. Adivasi community, or you can call them also as a tribal community. They are Dravidians whose origin can be traced to the pre-Aryan era. They are mainly found in Madhya Pradesh and its surrounding states. The word Gond comes from Gond, which means green mountains in the Dravidian idiom. The medium on which the Gond art act is also drawn, and various natural colors used in the processes are also mentioned in this lesson. So after dealing with the summary, let's see in detail what it has stolen for us. Now Gond art is a tribal art. As earlier explained or mentioned, it is a tribal art. Now tribal, as you all know the meaning, tribal are also known as the Adivasi people. It has been developed and preserved by Gond tribal people residing largely in the Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Odisha states of India. That means they had been residing largely in these states only. That is Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Odisha, these five states. From their traditional tales and mythology, we learn that they had lived in India for thousands of years, even before the other inhabitants came here. That means they had been living here from the ancient times. And the Gondi language, it is similar to Telugu or Dravidian language. They had mentioned about the similarity, that is, it is in the same as the Telugu language, and it is also known as the Dravidian language. Now one more example is given here. Gond art has spread mainly in the central India. Originally people used to draw the pictures on the earthen walls of the house. Most folk arts involve natural techniques of preparing colors and use of the several mediums. That means in the earlier days, how they used to do, they used to prepare whatever colors were there very naturally. They are transferred from generation to generation in a smoothly flowing process. Now, smoothly flowing process, obviously, whatever we had learned from our ancestors, the same thing and the same tradition we have been continuing, right? So here also, whatever we had learned or whatever they had learned, they had transferred it from one generation to another generation. And it has been still going on in a smoothly flowing process, means what? Very, very smoothly. That means everybody is following that same particular trend. Gone art is no exception to this. See, as our culture, as our tradition is being passed on from the one generation to another, that legacy is being carried on. Similarly also, gone art is also no exception. The same art is being still carried on. A house decorated with a beautiful pictures creates a pleasant atmosphere. Definitely nobody likes a house which is dirty and messy. I hope nobody likes, right? Correct. So a house decorated with a beautiful pictures creates a pleasant atmosphere. We feel happy, we feel contented, we feel satisfied when you look around and we have a pleasant atmosphere. Also, art is a medium of recording and preserving what is seen. Now here they had mentioned about the meaning of the art. Art is a medium of recording and preserving what is seen. Now whatever you see and whatever you feel, whatever appeals you, you feel like preserving it. So similarly, here also they had mentioned that the gone art is being preserved. In folk art, you yourself prepare the canvas. Usually nowadays we get ready-made canvas, and then with the help of the brush and with the help of the pencil and colors, we start painting on it. But in the folk art, you yourself prepare the canvas and the surface on which to draw and the colors with which you draw. That is why creating folk art is very enriching experience. Now here they have mentioned the difference between how do you paint on a simple canvas, but here in the folk art, you yourself have to prepare that canvas. That is very enriching experience. It is very delighting experience. And this richness is being reflected in the choice of the medium. Choice of the medium, what they want as a medium, on what they want to paint. In the days of past, now here they are mentioning about the past days, several things in the nature such as the soils or the different shades and the juice of the plants, leaves, tree bark, flowers, fruits and even things like coal and cow dung were used to prepare colors. Now see how they used to prepare color by using all these materials, that is the soil, soil of the different shape. We have a black soil, we have brown soil, red soil, and the juice of the plants, then leaves and leaf bark, fruits. Even with the coal and the cow dung also they used to prepare colors. How fascinating it is. The colors, now here they have mentioned the different colors, various textures and the paint and patterns were being used. Now see, day by day, whatever thing is being seen by us in a form of art, in form of fashion, in form of anything, it is going on changing, correct? So here also we find that the colors and various textures and the patterns were used year after year, lending a simplicity to the art. One more example, see how beautifully and how simplifically they had done this. Now when we see these pictures, we realize that a picture drawn in this way or the other can look equally beautiful. What a deep thought this art conveys, and so easily. That means if you reverse the picture or you change the angle, whichever form you do, it look equally beautiful and will be interpreted by a person on his own whims and fancies. In the gaunt style of the art, we see that the outlines may vary a little from artist to artist. Now, outlines might vary, that means outlines may be different from an artist to artist, but the designs that fill it make the whole picture look lively and attractive. Whatever designs they have made, it looks them what very lively and attractive. The design looks simple, textures achieved using dots, straight lines, dotted lines, then curvy shapes, circles. These all designs include very simple textures, and they are being made by using dots, straight lines, or the curvy shapes and circles. Special attention is given to the choice of various colors so that the total effect is amazing and beautiful. Now here, they have mentioned about the speciality of the colors, how they choose their color. Now they choose various form of the colors so that it looks not only attractive, it is appealing to others also. In today's age of the commercialization, many men have taken up gone art, but the roots of the folk art probably lies in the woman's daily course, like cleaning and decorating the house and then dealing with the natural colors in the course of the cooking and in the leisure time activity. So here we find that whatever form of the art it is still the legacy is being carried on from one generation to another, and the examples they have mentioned here is like cleaning and decorating house. Obviously everyone likes how the house should be neat and clean and beautiful, and as per your convenience, as per your whims and fancies, as per your choice, whatever you like, the way you want to live and the way you want to decorate. Everybody likes to decorate the house and keep it neat and clean and tidy. So whatever we are doing today, it is also the legacy passed from that generation to today's generation. So still we are doing the same thing. And so here they had mentioned that the woman's daily course, like cleaning and decorating the house and dealing with the natural colors and of cooking. Now even in the cooking also, how we make how we blend the various form of vegetables, various colors, and then how we decorate it, how we present our food. So all this is also one of the kind of the gone art, and whatever is being done, it is being done during the leisure time when you are relaxed and when you are very creative. See, when you are relaxed at that time, whatever activity you do, it is full of creativity. And whenever you are in a state of fatigue, whenever you are very tired, at that time you cannot concentrate on anything. You just want to relax, you just want to have your peace of mind. But here they have mentioned that whenever they are at the leisure time, that means they are at relaxed time, or whenever they have their free time and they do something creatively, and the creativity is not only in the form of the painting, but also it is reflected in the form of the food, and in the form of the cleaning, in the form of the decorating the house. And so that legacy is being still carried on, and it will be still passed on from the one generation to another. So I hope that you all have understood various form of the art, and even the importance of the gone art. So whenever you have any time of the leisure, at that time you can do whatever is being creative according to y'all. That means it can include not only the various painting, but also your cleaning of the house and your decorating of the house, so that your creativity is enhanced. So I hope that you all have liked the educational video very much. Kindly like it and subscribe it. Thank you once again, and God bless you all.